Welcome back to another episode of IoT with smartphones, or if you will, Cumulocity Hacks.
In this video, you will see how to use the accelerometer to find out if your smartphone is crashing and how to define rules to automate processes and decisions. I'd recommend watching the video called IoT with Smartphones Part 2 on this channel. Now here's the scenario. Let's imagine your smartphone falls down onto the ground. Most likely it will crash and you won't be available anymore. How could you let your friends know? Coming back to the accelerometer example from the previous video. I admit, speaking about acceleration is kind of confusing. If you put your smartphone flat on the table, you don't accelerate it at all, right? However, there's still an amplitude on the Z axis, whereas X and Y axis equal zero. That is the reason why some experts prefer to speak about forces rather than acceleration, because, as you can see here, this amplitude is minus 1G. Or if you flip the phone, it equals 1G, which is exactly the force of gravity. The accelerometer in a smartphone on a perfectly even table measures exactly 0.01. You may be familiar with some very useful apps which analyze exactly these three values of the accelerometer, commonly known as water bubble apps. These apps measure and calculate the precise value other than this optimum and visualize them in some water bubble-like images. Identifying data patterns. Last chance. For simplicity reasons, you may switch off the other data points and focus on the Z axis, which is affected by gravity. What happens if you throw your smartphone in the air? From the moment the smartphone leaves your hand, there's no force which keeps gravity from affecting the phone. Thus, gravity equals zero. By the way, that's true for all axes and likewise applies for the free fall. If you define all axes equals zero to be a pattern, you can conversely assume whenever a smartphone shows this pattern in a period of time, that the phone is falling down. The hardest part, however, starts when the falling part ends. Once the phone crashed down onto the ground, you are most likely not able to tell your friends that you cannot be reached until you bought a new one. Automate decisions and processes. What you can do, though, is to let your IoT platform recognize this pattern and automate an appropriate action. Two simple steps. First, recognize the pattern. Click on the three dots right to the data point. Save it to the library. Click on the three dots again and create a smart rule which will be triggered by this data point. Choose on measurement explicit threshold, create alarm. Give it a name, select acceleration Z as the data point, and define the threshold borders somewhat close to zero gravity. Give the alarm a technical name and a description that makes some more sense. Then click Create. You can see this smart rule now on the Info tab, and you can see the alarms that are generated by this rule on the Alarms tab. Please note, the alarm is only visible for the time that the pattern is recognized. In other words, as long as the smartphone is falling. For that reason, it's a good idea to turn on the Show Cleared Alarm switch. Second, automate an action. Same as before, click on the three dots and create another smart rule which will be triggered by the alarms from the previous smart rule. Choose On Alarm, Send Email and fill the blanks as required. Rule name, email addresses of your friends and click on Create. To wrap it up, when the smartphone is falling, the sensor data measures 0G. Your first smart rule recognizes your defined pattern and creates an alarm. Your second smart rule is triggered by this alarm and automatically sends an email according to your specification. Admittedly, these were very generic examples, and of course you're wondering what they got to do with the Internet of Things.
The answer is simple. What you have just seen here is the basis of IoT. Connecting sensors and collecting sensor data in an IoT platform. Analyzing sensor data and recognizing data patterns. Deriving information and defining rules. possibly also the automation of processes and decisions.
Granted, this was a very simple example, but you need to start somewhere, and the sky is the limit.
It's most fun if you work with several people and have several smartphones at your disposal.
You can start right now, or you can have a look at some more videos in our video channel. Have fun!